Hi, it's Inti K, Yard Sales Arena, here with some of our bloopers, or errors, mistakes. Like everybody, on occasion, we make mistakes, and we pick up something that we think's worth quite a bit, and we get it home, and uh-oh, we made a mistake. Here's one of our mistakes. We were at a yard sale recently, it was starting to rain, they had a lot of neat items, and I saw this. How cool is this? Look at this, push it up. It is broken, but that's something that I can repair. And it comes up like this. It says, Horseshoe brand number one clothes wringer down here, Empire clothes dryer. So this would mount on your wall and you would use it to dry your clothes, hang your clothes on and dry. That is really a neat item. But you know, when I was looking at it, a little bell went off in my head and said, that kind of looks like a repro. I asked the woman who was running around trying to put all of her items away, and she assured me that this was the real deal. Now, I don't know if she just didn't know or if she was lying to me. I can tell you I will never go back and buy anything from her again, but it is a reproduction. I paid $10 for it, and it's worth about $40 even as a reproduction. I think new these sell for about $79. They do have some of these that are antiques, and I'm going to continue to look for one. But even this is a pretty interesting, unique item to hang in your laundry room or in your bathroom and put some towels on. So I still think it makes a really nice decor piece.
It's pretty neat.
It is pretty neat. So even though it was a blooper, it's a pretty neat blooper. All right. Another one of my mistakes, at the Goodwill. You know, I collect oil lamps. This is a really nice old oil lamp. It had a chimney and everything on it. I paid $8 for that. I saw this on here, and I thought that was just some residue left from something that they had put in the lamp, and I thought I could clean that. I came home and I cleaned and I cleaned and I cleaned. You can't clean this out. Somebody put something in this oil lamp that etched the glass. The only way to get that out is to tumble it, if you happen to have a tumbler, or take it someplace where they can do that. And it really, frankly, is just not worth the cost. So live and learn. If you see an oil lamp with this kind of cloudy etching in it, do not buy it. Another just interesting item about oil lamps is if you're looking to date the oil lamp, you can usually do that by the burner. Most of the burners will have the maker's name on this little knob that is used to twist the wick up and down. And then you can look, the various companies that manufacture the burners went out of business at certain dates, so you can know that, at least narrow down the date. Okay, another thing about oil lamps is that a lot of people convert the old oil lamps to electric lamps so that they can use them. They find that to be a little more functional for them. And that is in the example with this. How can you tell? Well, usually it's going to have a nice bowl where you could put the oil, and you can look up at the socket for the lamp and see where the cord comes out. You can see this socket is up at the top and the cord is coming out right from the socket. If this was made to be a lamp, the cord would most likely be threaded down through the lamp and come out through the base. So that's kind of a giveaway for that. Now, you might look at this and go, well, gee, that doesn't look like an oil lamp to me, because doesn't the burner twist on? And they do, but there's two types of burners. One is one where the threading is on the oil lamp, and a cap would twist on. What would you call that, I guess? External?
External
burner?
Thread on the glass.
On the outside. Thread on the outside of the burner. All right. This one is not like that. This one is internal. And this here is an example of an internal. So you twist this out, and the thread is actually on the burner. So it goes internal to it. So
threads are on both of them, but
well, the threads are on both of them, but the burner goes inside, not on the outside. The cap does not go on the outside.
So they put put a stopper in there and they kind of glued it in.
Right, they could put a stopper and they glued it in. You could pry this out and convert
and then,
it back.
And then they put a brass washer on it to cover up the rubber stopper.
The stopper that they put in there, right. And this is glued down, but you could pry it open and you could convert this back to an oil lamp if you wanted to. Pretty neat, eh? I don't know what I'm going to do with this one. This is a really nice old lamp. I'm torn. Leave it like a electrified or convert it back. I don't know. We'll see. All right. That's it for this, the special segment of the yard sale show. We'll be back soon with more yard sale finds. See you then. Bye.